What is going on, guys? It is Master Rolf here. Welcome back to Clash of Clans and welcome back to another video. Today we're going to be doing all Wallbreakers and we're going to go and try and destroy a base easily. Now, we've done this before where we've attempted it, but I can't actually remember doing it. So we're going to give it another go, and today hopefully is going to be the day where we're going to do it. So I'm sorry for the quality loss. I'm currently away in Helsinki, Finland at the Supercell HQ. That is the makers of Clash of Clans. So I'm currently there on a super secret project basis that you'll find out on my channel very, very soon. Anyway, let us go into the clouds. We are currently in bronze 2. Just try. Oh, yes. This is perfect. So what we're going to do, you know what? We're not even going to go for tactics. We're just going to spawn up all of our troops and see what happens. Are you ready for this? Let's go. So in goes the Clan Castle troops. In goes all my wall breakers. Look at this absolute madness. Oh my days. Spawning in 2 rage spells. This is absolutely crazy. Go for the town hall. Town hall's been dropped. Yes, baby, it has. Everything is going down. We've got Wallbreakers running around like madmen here wanting to destroy stuff. It comes down to the final camp and boom, that is possibly the quickest Wallbreaker raid I have done. But don't worry, guys, that is not the only raid you're going to see today. Before this, I have actually done 2 Wallbreaker raids. So I actually already knew that this was going to work today. And we've got 200%. We've now got 300%. But I can confirm that was the quickest one I have done ever. That was just crazy. So I'm going to show you these ones. Whereas that one was just a mass suicide running out and everything. This was more of a tactical, if there is such thing as a tactical or Wallbreaker raid, this is it. So we throw out a few Wallbreakers to start off with. Picking up the walls, and we slowly put them out so that they pick at specific walls, except for this guy that seems to run across the other side and just wants to play like bulldog or something. It just runs across the other side. I slowly take out his walls because obviously we have to take out the walls first, and we make sure we do it so that the cannon is focused on one. It takes a few hits, but obviously the wall breakers won't die from that cannon unless it gets quite a lot of hits. Even there, it took about 8 and it didn't kill it. So we finish that wall off with this wall breaker, and then we'll start on the final kind of straight we've got here. So we'll spawn a few up. The archer tower is actually shooting down on us, but again, it doesn't do enough damage to take them out one shot. Not even 2 shots. It takes about 4 or 5 from them, and that is it. All the walls have now been taken out. Now comes the tactical part. We throw down a rage spell along with everything we have in our clan castle. The rage spell, I think, doubles the hit points or something. So that does really, really well for us. Luckily, it covers the town hall as well, so we throw a few more wall breakers in on the town hall to get it down, and it's on about probably a 3rd damage. I throw another rage spell down so we can take out the cannon straight away, and we also take out the elixirs and the gold storages, as you can see, just like that. We throw another pair in, and we make sure that the wall breakers stay raged, either staying in the rage zone or staying that little bit of rage you get, like an after rage, an afterburner. Another rage spell is dropped. We throw a few more in, and again, it's just dropping them off now. We've got like 20, we got 38 left even, and we don't even need them. Tactically done. Defender cool, not so cool anymore after we've taken him out with our Wallbreaker raid. So let's go watch this final one. This was probably the hardest one. I don't know why. It was a little bit harder because it probably had the mortar in the center there. But we throw a few out to start off with, just breaking a load of the walls. Sadly, they leave one wall like that, which is really annoying. But they kind of get split up. This guy wants to run through everything and goes for a wall on the other side. I have no idea what he wanted to do that for, but it worked, thank God. And again, this guy, look at him running across. And he didn't even explode. He died. Wow, that was a waste. So it works quite well. You have to be quite tactical. I think they can take about, I think it's like 3 or 4 out at a time, which is actually pretty good when you think about it. So we throw them in slowly. These guys have probably no idea what's happening. They might not even have seen a wall breaker yet, and they're just getting their base destroyed by them. It is so much fun to do. It's so much fun to pick them off. And I'm so sorry, Drago, that this is happening to you, but you were my target. You were my victim for my suicide wall breakers. All right. So there we go. Everything's taken out. As you can see, all the walls have gone. So now comes the tactical part. We drop a few out on this side to take out the elixir collectors, but there's also a cannon there. There's actually 2 cannons and a mortar covering that area. So it's quite dangerous. So we throw a few wall breakers in, take out the one initial archer tower. So luckily that section is now okay. I throw a rage spell along with a lot of wall breakers that just destroys that cannon, destroys the barracks, and starts picking off and destroys the mortar. The other cannon's dropped, and now it's just a game of how do you put them out to destroy everything. So I throw a few wall breakers at the top, a few wall breakers at the middle, throwing them in there with the rage spells just to make sure that they get that all important extra hit points, and they start dropping the collectors, start dropping the storages, and they go for the Town Hall, which actually doesn't have much health. I believe it's a Town Hall 3 or whatever, so that starts dropping quite quickly. We get a massive 3 experience points for it as well. It's actually quite an easy way to get experience points, taking out lower levels. You don't get many, but it's pretty good fun. I throw in another Rage Spell along with some more troops to take out the final Collector Builder's Hut. And finishing it off right here on this army camp is our lone load of Wallbreakers. Throwing them in slowly so we don't have to waste them, as you can see, and then just blowing it up like nothing else. So there it is, guys. There is the all Wallbreaker wave. We have completely demolished people with it, with a few different tactics. I hope you enjoyed it, just trolling some low levels for now, as I'm away in Helsinki. It's a nice, easy video for me to do, and it is great fun, and I hope you guys enjoy it. But until next time, guys, thank you so much for watching. Make sure to leave a like and also leave a comment down below. But until then, peace out.